Hello and welcome to Red Stapler channel. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create a snow effect using CSS box shadow and without any background image at all. Ready? Let's check it out. The key concept of this project is to use CSS box shadow to create a snow layer on each div. Then apply various blur filter on each snow layer to create depth of field effect. And finally, apply the animation. This may sound a little bit complicated, but don't worry, we'll work on it step by step. Let's create the first layer of the snow, and then on to the CSS. Since this project involves generating random snow particles, we'll be using SCSS to achieve that. First, let's apply a radial gradient background to the wrapper. For our snows, set the border radius to 50% to form a circle and the opacity to 80%. And next, we'll define the properties of the first snow layer. Set the width and height to 1.5 rem and apply a small amount of blur filter. And here comes the key part of this tutorial. In previous video, we used box shadow to create an 8-bit pluggable image. We'll do something similar for this project, except that we will create a for loop to random the position for each snow particle. Create a variable and a for loop that runs 400 times. This will be the number of snow particles for each layer. For each run, I will random the x and y position using viewport units, then concat with 0 blur radius. And concat with spread parameter using random negative value. This will create a various snow size. And finally concat with white color. I will also add a condition to concat, comma, except the final run. Now it's time to apply this with the box shadow. Alright, that looks good. It's time that we work on another layers. I'm going to create 3 layers of snow. Let's duplicate all the code from the first one. To create depth of field effect, I'm going to reduce the size and increase the blur of the second and third layers. Okay, now let's work on animation. I'm going to create a linear infinite animation that moves the snow downward. Also set the position of the snow to starting position. To maintain the depth of field effect, I'm going to make the back layers move slower than the front using animation duration. Almost done. Now, to create a seamless animation, we will duplicate each layer and then set the animation delay on one of them with the half of the duration. The trick is to use negative value. This will offset the animation to skip the part where the snow is moving into the screen. And here's the result. So that's it. Hope you guys enjoy. You can find the link for the Pokeball 8-bit image tutorial below. If you love this video, please feel free to like or subscribe to stay with us or follow the Facebook page for interesting updates. Thanks for watching and see you next time. Bye!